Okay, so PC Andy Stevenson from the Warwickshire Rural Crime Team, joined today by Sergeant Robert Shaw. We're going to have a quick discussion about purchasing of second-hand horse boxes and motorhomes. Things for you to look out for when you're purchasing it, and then when you do get it home, what you need to do to maybe prevent being a victim of crime in the future. So how best to protect your purchase when you've got it. So when looking at making such a substantial purchase as this, I would always recommend taking it to a specialist for them to make sure all the appropriate checks can be done and that it's got an appropriate MOT or HGV equivalent, depending on the size of the horse box that you're looking at buying. A couple of things that you can initially check before doing that are things like making sure that the V5 documentation is accurate and that the serial number on that V5 matches what is stamped into the VIN, and we'll show you that in a moment. Also that the engine number is the accurate one to the engine that's in the vehicle. We have had occasions where we've come across vehicles that have got stolen engines in them, but on the outside it all looks perfectly fine. So a couple of things that I would initially look at doing: you can gain access to the engine, try and find the engine number in here. Quick Google search will generally tell you on any lorry or vehicle where the VIN numbers and engine numbers should be located, and then you'd be able to check the V5 documentation matches what the engine should be, or the engine number should have on it. So that's a nice quick and easy check that you can do yourself. So there's a couple of things inside the cab that you need to check. I'll just get Sergeant Shaw to take you through those now.
Okay, so when you're checking the vehicle over, you're now inside the cab. There's a few things to look out for. These vehicles, some of them are semi-agricultural, some of them are really plush, so you're going to have different levels of trim. Are you looking for things out of place, seams that don't fit, things that, you know, that don't look right in that vehicle? And they will ring alarm bells with you, and you need to just follow those through and check them out. Other basic things you can do is check the mileage. Apps such as Vehicle Smart, you can put the registration in, you can actually get the MOT history. That's useful for yourself if you're considering buying as well. You get the MOT history, you see whether there's been advisories, but more importantly you get the mileage of each of the MOT, so you can check the last one, check on the display, what is the mileage, is that close, has it been clocked, you know, does it all tie in. Okay, so as well as checking the trim, the mileage and other things that look out of place, are the seats right? You know, do they fit naturally? Have they been put in? Because we find some vehicles are a concoction of bits from other vehicles, some stolen, some legitimate. Are the seats right? You will be able to tell fairly easily on most vehicles. Of course, this is dependent on vehicle type, vehicle age, but something else to check. Okay, so here we are in the accommodation section of your horse box transporter. Similar to the cab, really, you're looking for fixtures and fittings that don't fit, you know, seams that don't look right, because build quality should be pretty good in these vehicles. You know, some of them are luxurious, some of them not so, but even so, that, you know, things that aren't, that shouldn't be there, will stand out hopefully like a sore thumb. On top of the fixtures and fittings, start asking about the 12 volt electric supply. A lot of trackers are connected to that, so that if that's not connected, you need to ask why and investigate that. So the points I've raised, any legitimate seller will be really happy to answer all of these, and there'll be no problems with that.
Thank you very much, Sergeant. Couple of things to be checking on the outside of the vehicle and just inside the door shuts. So as alluded to, there are a couple of applications that you can use, like Vehicle Smart, to check the status of the vehicle. HPI is another one of those. That'll tell you if there's any outstanding finance on the vehicle. And it's about £15 to £30 for a check, and is well worth doing before you do commit to the purchase of the vehicle. In relation to the serial number or VIN number, there is usually a plated VIN number somewhere on the vehicle. Again, Google will tell you where that is. If you put in the manufacturer and year of the vehicle, Google will tell you where all the VIN numbers and serial numbers are for the whole of the vehicle. This one's located in the passenger door shut, and it will tell you the vehicle VIN number. That is also printed, stamped in on one of the chassis or rail frames of the vehicle. It's worth checking that one to make sure that none of the digits have been altered or adjusted, and that they match. When you're looking at the VIN number plates, it's worth checking that the actual rivets haven't been drilled out, moved, and that they look proper. You can see on this one, and we'll show you in a second a bit closer, that just on the edges of the VIN plate there is just some green showing. That tells me that this vehicle was originally green. So again, worth checking with the DVLA that that change of colour has been notified to them, and ask the person that's selling it, why is this green? Has it been resprayed? If they can't tell you, or it's a little bit, information isn't forthcoming, then as with the caravan video we did the other week, I would be walking away. So we're going to go and have a look at the motorhome now. Many of the things that we've checked on this horse box, you will be looking for on the motorhome as well. So the VIN numbers, the serial numbers, and also doing the appropriate checks with Vehicle Smart and HPI. However, there are a couple of other little things that I want to point out that are well worth checking before you do hand over any money.
These are quite expensive vehicles. You know, you can pay up to £90,000 for something of this size. They're of really good, high quality build quality. So we'd be looking at things such as the seam joining what we would call the carrier chassis, which is a standard light goods vehicle base, and the bit that's put on the back, which is the bit that you live in. And we have actually recovered, the Warwickshire Rural Crime Team have recovered I won't call it a stolen motorhome, it was a motorhome that had the accommodation section was stolen, and it was fitted to a legitimate chassis which wasn't stolen. So all the engine number, the chassis number, the number in the windscreen, the chassis number, they were all legitimate, came back to a legitimate vehicle, but everything in the back was stolen. We had to identify that by means other than the vehicle chassis number. So on that vehicle in particular, this seam round here was a poor fit, it was poor quality. As I say, these are high quality vehicles, and you will not get that standard of finish on a legitimate vehicle. If there's anything untoward with that, then ask questions, and I would walk away at an early stage.
So you've done the appropriate checks inside and outside of the motorhome, and also the horse box. You've decided you're buying the item and you get it home. When you get it home, a couple of things that you really need to be considering to best secure it, so you're not a victim of crime going forward. One of the massive points that we would suggest is a tracker. Something like this, even if your motorhome or horse box has a built-in tracker from manufacturer, we would always suggest fitting a third-party tracker, one that you can install yourself in a location that's not known to anybody other than you. Trackers these days, they can cost anywhere from £30 up to £200, and they all have varying subscription charges. Some of them don't have subscription charges. But we would suggest that you do look at fitting one of these items, as potentially offenders are quite adept at removing factory fitted trackers, unfortunately. So what other items can you fit to your purchase to best secure it? Well, wheel clamps, wheel locks, in much the same vein as a caravan where you'd use a hitch lock or a wheel lock on that. Your motorhome, when you're not using it and it's parked or in storage, you want to be considering using a wheel lock or wheel clamp. We appreciate that many insurance companies insist on these items being fitted to be valid or to have valid insurance. So look at which ones your insurance company approve and go with those ones. Extra and on top of that, especially if the item isn't going to be used for long periods of time, you may want to consider ground anchors. This is effectively where you have a D-ring mounted into a concrete floor or into the driveway of your house, and you can secure it with a very hefty chain and a very substantial lock. It's one of those items that maybe offenders aren't going to be looking for, or if they do spot it, they're not going to bother going after your item, as potentially one further down the road doesn't have these things. Unfortunately, it is quite a lot about making your item less desirable to offenders, and they will go somewhere else. So on behalf of the Warwickshire Rural Crime Team, thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video. Hopefully it means that somebody isn't purchasing something that's maybe not quite as advertised, and just gives you a couple of ideas as to what to look for and how best to protect yourself. This is part two of a three-part video. The next video will contain quad bikes and trailers, stock trailers and normal trailers. So tune in for that one. We'll publish that on our Facebook channel, but also on our YouTube channel, and maybe even on TikTok if there's a couple of funny moments.